So we're asked to do a display for both mixing tank 1 and storage tank 1. So maybe I can start by looking for my mixing tank. Great, mixing tank 1 is here. So the first thing we'll do is build a trend. So always know that I select the symbol first, and then we'll go and select the attributes. So in this trend, we want both the internal and the external temperature in the same trend. So once I have my trend, I'm also asked to do a trend for the level and the level forecast. So in this case, I'm just selecting both and then just drag and drop. But I could also select one at a time and just drop it on the same trend. We now want to create a table with the product in it. So I select my table. I select my product attribute. And then I can have it on this table. Well, maybe I don't want to have all of these, so I will go and configure the table to simply show the name and the value. The next one we want to do is put the asset name as a value. So the asset name is just an attribute. I will select the value symbol, move it on here, and the same thing. The name of the asset having the timestamp does not make much sense, therefore we'll just remove that. And I have the name of my asset. The next thing I want to get is from the production area. So this is done for my mixing tank 1, and I'll have to do the same thing for the storage tank 1 afterwards. Okay, great. So now let's move on to doing the production area that we want on the display. So what we can do is we can just look for our element. So here I can see that it searched for some of the attributes, but I'm interested in the production area. So for the production area, I only want the asset name. Here's one little shortcut. So in this case, let's assume that I want to always just put the name of the value of the asset name, and I don't want it to show the timestamp, and I don't want it to show the production area pipe asset name. So what I can do instead, here I'm simply deleting it, and I can take one that's already formatted the way I want. I'm going to copy and paste it. And then I can drag and drop the value of the asset on top of it. And now the value has been replaced. So this allows you to just save some time when you have a format that you want to use for other things. In this case, we also want the asset names of the production lines. So if we move to one of the production line, we can do the same thing. So I'll copy and paste. And I'll drag and drop the production over the production area. So now I know that I have mixing tank 1 into my production line 1. And one more time is I can select many of the symbols, I can move them around, and maybe I want to arrange them so it looks a little bit nicer, so I can align them to the left. And I can have my production line 1. And then I can move on to do my storage tank 1, my production line 2, and my mixing tank 2, storage tank 2. So here's the result of what your display could look like. And really, the way the display looks does not matter too much. This is really, you want it to be easy for you to turn that data into intelligence, being able to quickly see what's going on your plant. So in this case, I've just added some pictures, but mostly we have both production lines here and then all four of my tanks on my graphics.